We're going to talk about rigid bronchoscopy and its role in pulmonary medicine. This is a very rarely taught modality in the practice of pulmonary medicine, and it is absolutely essential that you get exposed to this modality so that you can move forward as far as interventions are concerned, and this becomes a basis for most of the interventional procedures in pulmonology. All right. Now, what exactly is it? It is just a hollow tube with a telescope going through that, and you're going to visualize the trachea and the proximal bronchi, and it is usually done under general anesthesia. I've seen it being done under local anesthesia and conscious sedation, but let me assure you, extremely uncomfortable, and I don't think you should be doing that at all. But this is one of the most important modalities to manage patients with anything in the central airway, obstruction central airway, meaning the trachea and the main bronchi. If you have an obstructive lesion there of critical obstruction, then this would be the instrument of choice to go ahead and do any of these things. And it has got a large lumen which facilitates easy suctioning and introduction of good amount of instruments, and to introduce the flexible bronchoscope also, which will serving as a conduit for the flexible bronchoscope, which will automatically mean that you can use the entire armamentarium of instruments that you have with the flexible bronchoscopy along with the rigid bronchoscope. So the advantages over a flexible bronchoscope is that it has a large lumen, it's got excellent optics, and you can remove all the debris and a huge quantity of that. And the main advantage probably is that the sharp edges of the bronchoscope at the terminal, at the tip of the bronchoscope, facilitates coring, which would be to your advantage if you have to core through a tumor as an emergency to create an airway. And that's what it is. So.